A new study funded by the National Institute of Environmental Health Sciences finds that perfluorinated compounds, or PFCs, widely used in manufactured products such as nonstick cookware, waterproof clothing, and fast food packaging, were associated with reduced vaccine effectiveness in children. Philippe Grandjean from the Harvard School of Public Health led the study, and he offered his thoughts on PFCs and their effect on the immune system.
PFCs have been around for like 50 years. They've turned out to be incredibly useful as water and stain repellent compounds. So you use them for surface treatment. You use them for, you know, textiles, rain gear, shoes to protect them against water seeping through. You use them for your rugs, your furniture upholstery, so that if you pour some coffee, then it just runs off the surface without creating a stain. This is what these compounds do. But the problem is that we're not only exposed from, you know, textiles or from food packaging, we're also exposed because these compounds have entered the environment and the food chain. So now they're coming back to us through the food also. The finding was very surprising to us in that the kids with the highest exposure to the PFCs, they had the poorest response to the vaccines and the greatest chance that even after four vaccinations that the child would not be protected. What we saw was that when the PFC exposure doubled, the child lost about half of the antibody concentration, which is a steep decline. Sometimes we see that the vaccination doesn't take, and we don't know why. So then we discovered this, and then we realized, wow, maybe it's environmental chemicals doing this. There are animal studies that demonstrate that these compounds do have biochemical effects. In particular, we know from very recent studies that the PFCs prevent the white blood cells from sending hormone signals to each other, cytokines, special substances that where one type of immune cell signals to the next, get going, there is a foreign protein here or a vaccination, we need to produce antibodies. So the PFCs inhibit that response. I guess the paradox is that it's going to take us many years to come to the bottom of this situation with the PFC effect on the immune system. What does it really mean? What are the long-term implications? Are there infectious diseases involved? What about other diseases? It's going to take us many, many years to understand that. And in the meantime, you would really like to prevent these exposures because they may be hazardous to your child. Do what you can to avoid these compounds in the products that you bring to your home. And since products are coming out on the market now that are PFC-free, perhaps this will create a niche for safer materials. We will continue looking at the immune system dysfunctions associated with PFC exposure, and we will certainly also look at allergy, and we'll look at other vaccines, and we'll look at infectious disease. The spectrum may be even wider and also relate to non-communicable disease like cancer or autoimmune diseases like type 1 diabetes. So we shouldn't just stop with vaccinations and infectious disease. We should also think of what the immune system does in general